today I'm so excited to be back with a beauty video. I feel like it's been so long since I've done a beauty video because of just everything that's been going on with my computer, and I haven't done a real review in a while, so I'm so excited. This actually came in PR and I've been wanting to do a review on this. I showed you guys on Snapchat and I was really excited because it's a product I've never heard of before, this type of product. It came a while ago, I just hadn't been able to film and edit, that kind of thing. So today is finally going to be the Urban Decay Lo-Fi Lip Mousse. I think mousse. I remember asking you guys, because I'm not that great at English, I guess. More than one mousse as in an animal is just mousse, but mousse as in what these are is mousses. That's the plural. So took a little bit to figure that out. But I have the collection here. It is 8 colors. And we're gonna try them all on. You guys know what I think. Here on the paper, it says the perfectly undone pout. Get high impact color with lo-fi lip mousse.
Tap it on with fingertips for an effortless, blurred, just bitten look, or get precise with the pop-out applicator.
I did not notice that. Okay, awesome. I was literally looking through these and I did not see the applicator, so I'm excited to see what that is. Either way, lo-fi leaves lips soft, smooth, and stained with color. What's not to love? Okay, I'm really excited that it said soft because my lips definitely need to look soft because they don't usually. Let me show you guys some swatches of all 8 colors, and actually let me show you the packaging first. It's this little purple circle here in this compact. And it's this size compared to my hand. It says Lo-Fi UD on the front. And then you just open it like this. And there's a little mirror on it too, which is awesome because you want that for lip products. If you just want to take this, you don't have to bring an extra mirror. This is the color Wavelength. I can't believe, I just thought this was literally, I don't know, part of the closing mechanism. You can see there's like right here when you open it. That thing pops out. I'm in awe right now, this mechanism. So here's the applicator. Softer than a traditional sponge applicator. It's like a really soft one. Okay, I literally just scared myself to death. I'm only watching Juicy Star, but it started up without me knowing it. New computer has an external trackpad that I have to move around, so sometimes I'll place something on there. Oh my god. We have Wavelength, Noise, Fade, Echo, Amplify, Halo, Frequency, and Boom. So let's just look at the formula of this before I put up my lips for you guys. So we're gonna do lip swatches. It does definitely feel like a mousse, almost like a, have you ever had the Dream Matte Mousse, Dream Mousse from Maybelline? It definitely feels like that. It's very soft. And let's see, ooh. Oh wow, that's so cool. If you guys see, it's almost like it dries to a pout. I don't know the right word for it. But it, as you can see, when I'm running my finger over here, it doesn't feel sticky. It doesn't feel like I really have anything on here. If I wasn't looking at my hand, this would feel like absolutely nothing. I'm gonna be interested to see how it feels on my lips, but just from going like that, I can't feel anything from my fingertips. It's almost like it disappears, but the pigment is still there. That's pretty cool. Let's try one more color before I try them on my lips. I'm eyeing it. Frequency. So this one's the red one. It feels so cool. All right, so we're gonna put it here really quick. Wow. This formula is just unlike anything I've tried before. It really does almost feel like a blush, a much more pigmented blush. You wouldn't want to blush this kind of color. It'd be way too bright, but it feels like it's just disappearing almost to a powder finish. How crazy. Achieve that effortless cool girl pout. Now imagine it's like wearing nothing at all. We loaded our lo-fi formula with pigment, yet goes on weightlessly and won't budge. From a sheer bitten look to a super saturated modern matte effect. That's exactly what I was trying to get across when I say it kind of turns into a powder-like look at the end. And then I talked about the applicator, which I'm still like, what? That applicator came out of nowhere. I would have never known that was an applicator. So the first one is Wavelength, which is purple color. I use the applicator, see how that works. Chapped lips are bare and right there for you. This is such a unique formula. It really does feel like they found a way to put eyeshadow on your lips. Okay, so I'm definitely digging more into the mousse when I'm using this guy. I just looked in, there's like little things in there. Oh, this is a really pretty color. Doesn't match what I'm wearing now, but really pretty. Oh, I love this color. Let's try a blotting our lips on here, see if there's any transfer. Barely any. So that's what it has. There's like a tiny bit like right where my lip creased, I guess, because I put a little bit more towards the inner part of my mouth. But you can see where I kissed, there's like literally nothing. Yeah, so if I go like that, there's absolutely nothing then. I'm gonna wipe this off and we're gonna try the next color. This one is Noise. It's like a reddish maroon. This looks like a just bitten color for sure. All right, the next color. I do like that color though. This one is a brownish color. So that's gonna be interesting to see what it looks like on my lips. I do not wear browns very often. I've been told they look good on me, so I don't know, let's see. This is actually a lot lighter than I expected it to be. Super, super natural. This is actually a really nice color. I was expecting it to be more dark, I guess, but it actually, no, that's pretty much the color. This one for sure, if you're my lip color, when it does inevitably fade, even though it is long lasting, it's not going to be noticeable. Because of the formula, they're not gonna fade in a straight line that looks really awkward. I feel like it would be a lot more natural looking, a gradient into your lip color. All right, so this next color is Echo. This is another purple color, very similar to the first one. I'm gonna be a daredevil and try putting it all with my fingers. I'm getting it all over. Because if you want to make it very pouty and not really go to the very edge of your lips, then you could do it with your finger. But if you want to get to the edge, you do need the applicator. So good thing they put that in there. Okay, so this one's also a really, really pretty one. Let me just show you in comparison to the first, because that's the one I said was so much like it. They're not. I have really bad memory. They're definitely different. So this is the one I just have on right now, and this is the first one. So this one's definitely more purple. The next one we're gonna try on. That was like a really slow wrap intro. Amplify, which is a red color. Oh, I'm excited. Just so you guys know, if you haven't seen my review videos, at the very end I go over everything again and talk about my final thoughts more in depth than what I did earlier. This one, so pretty. That kind of color, it's like a red. This one I am 100% gonna use the applicator because it seems like a darker color. So this is probably my favorite color so far. The other ones are really pretty, but this one I feel like is more me. Even though I really don't wear red colors, I feel like I could pull this one off. What do you guys think? I like this one a lot. Okay, so that one was Amplify again. And we're gonna do Halo. This is the one that when I was swatching it, I swear this is gonna be my favorite. We're gonna see. But this is the nude color, of course. You guys know me and nudes. So I have high hopes for this one. High, high hopes. Anyone else thinking I'm Panic at the Disco song? Okay, I have a new technique. New technique that I like. I use this brush to go right around the edges, and then I just take my finger for the middle. Love it. Oh my god, this color. What I will say about this particular color though is if you're like me and have really badly chapped lips, this, because it is a more nude color, is going to bring out the chapping. So once my lips get better, this will be my color, but for now the red is top. That was the top color because it didn't show the chapping in my lips. Blends in, if you know what I mean. It also doesn't like accentuate any of the dryness. This one, because it is a more nude shade, can do that a little bit. But the color. Next color is another red one, a more warm color. But this is called Frequency. Let's take a look at that one. Let's try the technique again. I'm not good at this. We're not gonna stray away from the applicator. The applicator does great. I'm just clumsy. This might be presumptuous, but I think this is my favorite color. I'm really loving this. I feel like this actually almost matches this look a little bit. This was, what was the color again? Frequency. This is my new favorite. 100% I would wear this again. And the last one is gonna be Boom, which is a darker kind of purple color, so that one scares me. I always get comments from you guys saying you love me in dark lipsticks, but I am so scared of them. But when I try them on, I like them. I'm just so scared of them. So this is Boom. I can actually get down with this color. This reminds me of a wine kind of color. It's not crazy dark. It's more of a reddish purple. So I really, really do like that. The good thing also is that because of the formula and also because it's not a super, super dark color, you don't get that line in your lips. It's kind of like a fade in, if you can see. Great angle for me. All right guys, so I switched back to the Frequency. Final thoughts on this whole lip mousse collection, the lo-fis. Color wise, I really did like the colors. I thought they matched very well. I actually found a couple reds that matched my skin tone. That's pretty rare. Sometimes it can look a little clownish on me depending on the red color. It was definitely some my lips but better kind of colors. And also the nude was a very pretty color. But like I said, because my lips are so dry and chapped, I have a little bit of trouble with this one. So now for the actual textures of these. They are marketed and the writing on the back of this and on the back of the little packages says that they're meant to be a high pigmented mousse that you can build and that it's unmovable. It'll stay on your lips for a while. What I noticed when I was swatching them and also when I was putting them on my lips, it is 100% a mousse feel when you have your finger or the applicator in the little pan. And it goes on so smoothly. It glides on really easily. There's absolutely no tugging. When you guys saw when I was doing the swatches on my hand that it really wasn't going anywhere when I was lightly rubbing it, I did notice that when I really pressed down hard, like really crazily, there is slight movement, but that's also trying really hard to get it to move. So I definitely will say it stays on your lips so well, and also that it does fade very naturally. It's not going to create like a line. What it dries down to is a matte formula. Definitely keep that in mind if you do have dry lips. Matte is not always the best for really, really cracked lips. Although the darker colors, the reds especially, they weren't showing the chapping or anything. They were camouflaging my chapping pretty well. I didn't find them drying. I just felt like there was nothing on my lips. If I were to go like that, I don't feel anything on my lips. It really just feels like my bare lips. Let's see just this last one. I know I didn't try them for every single one, but the transfer is extremely minimal, so that's really nice. So these retail for $22 each. I would totally purchase this color, the red color. I think there was a purple in there that I really liked. I do really appreciate the formula. I think it would be perfect for back to school because of how well it fades, how little it feels on your lips, and I really feel like it would last you for a long time. I hardly used any by putting that on my lips because it is so pigmented.
And I also wanted to show you guys this where I rubbed my finger over my lips lightly and there is literally nothing on my finger.
They are gonna last a really, really, really long time on your lips. So I think they'd be great for wearing during the day. I'll have any other notes I have on these products down below. Sometimes I forget to put something in the video and then I think about it and it'll be right down there. And if you guys have any questions for me, definitely let me know and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.